This is Lewismadmax, the one who will still call the baby ugly.
Good day, everybody. I'm here to talk to you about healthcare insurance. The Obama plan, the Nancy Pelosi plan, the Chuck Schumer plan. Obama went to Nancy Pelosi, said, come up with a plan, use Chuck Schumer. Chuck Schumer basically wrote it. Now, I'll post a link to the bill. Here, it's the bill that went into the committee. We don't know what bill they voted on. Remember that transparency stuff? Yeah, they promised transparency. We could read all the bills. Well, it's a perfect time for us to read the bill as American people, but they won't post it. The only one posted is the bill that went into the committee. The bill that went into the committee, basically, they're saying you're going to get to keep your private coverage, and they're right. If you go to Section 102 on page 16, you get to keep your coverage. But the health insurance company is not allowed to make any changes. So say your doctor moves or retires. That's a change. You're going on the government health care roll at that point because they're not allowed to, you're grandfathered in, you're not allowed to transfer it. So any changes, if you choose to get a different prescription plan, that's a change. You're going to the health care exchange. On page 425, dealing with senior citizens, once you hit the age of 65, you're going to talk to an end-of-life counselor. What they're going to do, say you need a hip replacement. Well, that's an elective surgery, according to them. If you don't have 5 years of fruitful tax production ahead of you, they're going to say, oh, you don't have 5 years of fruitful tax production. We're going to go ahead and medicate you with pain pills instead of giving you the hip replacement surgery. You won't be mobile, but that's okay. Last time I checked, I lived in America. Last time I checked, we were a republic based on the rule of law. I understand we're based on the rule of law, but is it right under our Constitution for our Congress to pass a law that says if you don't have a health insurance, you're going to jail? There's tons of people in America that are so wealthy they don't need health insurance because they can pay cash for their treatment. We call a lot of them congressmen, but they pay cash. They don't need health insurance. So why force people that don't need it to have it? I don't think it'll hold constitutional muster, but it's not something that's created by people that are sworn to uphold and defend the Constitution of the United States of America, our congressmen, our senators, and our president. They're supposed to uphold and defend it, not write laws that betray it. And remember, if you speak out against it at a town hall meeting, you're just an angry mob. You're just a corporate shill. You're a hack. They ignore you if you speak out against it and tell them how you feel. Here in Florida, two congressmen canceled the town hall meeting. They won't even send their aides to them anymore because 59% of Americans, according to Quinnipiac, think this is wrong. They think it will add to the deficit, 59%. 52% disagree with the whole bill. On page 72, it deals with employers. It's basically going to put a lot of employers out of business. Well, not out of business. What they're going to do is they're going to pay employees less because they can't afford what this coverage will cost them. On page 909, which deals with affirmative action, times 10, because basically it gives preference to hospitals that receive federal aid. It gives preference to those hospitals that hire minorities, underserved individuals, things like that. Well, if you're a guy looking for a job and they say, I can't hire you because you're not black, aren't they discriminating against you because of your color? Thank you.